So in step four, we run the concept of profit funnels. And what we do is we generate ideas as the first step. In the second step, we validate those ideas with data. The third step, we design the changes we're going to do in the organization, take out waste, redesign a process, optimize it. The fourth thing is to implement what we've designed. And then the fifth thing is to track the financial benefits. And this is key, to try and track income statement benefits. If you're not getting income statement benefits, then you look at balance sheet or cash flow benefits. For instance, if you bring your inventory down, that's a balance sheet and cash flow impact. That's fine. We track those benefits. And lastly, if it's a non-financial project, well, we give it a proxy financial value and we still track the value through the five funnels. Now, what we find when we do the validate funnel is that a lot of business line managers struggle to validate their ideas with data. So this is where we can come in and help with data literacy skills and advanced analytics. We can show people how to analyze their data and then build models, business models that pretty much model what's going to happen before you make the changes to your business. So practically what we do, a funnel process looks something like this. We've got the five funnels: generate ideas, validate, design optimization, implement, and then track in the P&L. So let's say we run a workshop and the business says we need to improve pricing. Great. How much is that worth? We've got 100,000 rand here. This is the currency we're using here in South Africa. Could be $100,000. It doesn't matter. 100,000, we validate that improved pricing with some data. And then each week we track the progress of this project or sub-project until it reaches the P&L. And we are only satisfied once it reaches the fifth level in the P&L. We might have another project, train sales reps better. We also say it's worth 100,000, but when we validate it, we can only validate 40,000. We've lost the other 60,000. No problem. Let's move it forward and let's track it through the funnels. Next project, someone climbs up and says, let's reduce IT spend. 100,000 is the idea of how to reduce IT spend. But when you go to validate it, you're sure about 30,000, but you're not too sure about the 70,000. What we say is take the 30,000 and we will help you move that through the funnels and keep tracking the 30,000. The 70,000 you might never get to, which is fine, but it might be delayed. And in which case, once that happens, we can track the 70,000 through the funnels. Another example, rent new premises. You go and validate and guess what? Sometimes your innovation kicks in and you find that you can deliver more than what you thought you could. Well, that's brilliant. Improved quality of ops, 100,000. Maybe you can only get 80,000 and so forth. So I've got a list of 2, 4, 5 projects here. We'll tally each of those up and every week we'll present this funnel back to the team. It's a collective strategy. So everybody's aligned, everybody's seen the number. Everyone wants to see those numbers move across. And I tell you what, when you've seen the numbers move across the page, even if it's from column 1 to column 2, there's an energy that is created that creates momentum and you start creating this performance culture until hopefully eventually you've got a ton of projects that you've listed and you're not only working down the page, but more importantly, you're moving those values across the page and into your financial statements.